If you would like to get your song reviewed, dear listener, there's the Filthy Capitalist option. It's where he says, 125 gets you straight to the head of the line. You don't have to be a part of Alliance. You don't have to be part of the group.
Wait a minute.
And the biggest thing is you don't have to wait. You hop, skip, and jump right in front of everybody. 125 gets you there. You do that 3 times and then get mashed down to the $75 rate for perpetuity.
Yes!
Also, there is a band review option. So if you've got a band and you're trying to get your band some exposure, hit me up at insori@gmail.com and I'll show you the details about how to pull
you
that off.
You can also jump on Patreon and there is a option on the tiers to be able to get your band reviewed. Yep. Obviously, we can't lie to you, so we
can't guarantee a positive review.
Get what you get.
It's just rubbish.
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 That's British for garbage.
My favorite is the community option. $1 at the gate gets you in a Patreon. You get to join an alliance. The alliance joins their points together, and that helps determine what songs that we do.
The alliances hang out on Discord.
Message me on Patreon to get the link.
And they do all kinds of other cool things. They do Minecraft. What? Dungeons and Dragons.
Yeah, yeah. It's really a community within the community. Anybody can go in the village, facebook.com/VinandSori. There's 160,000+ people on the channel. What's cool about the Discord is that it offers a real opportunity for community, connection, friendship, that type of thing.
But, and it's on Discord, so if you're not a Facebook person, it's for you.
You start off at $1.
Right.
Plus you get exclusives. Sori and I are working on a song. So the first 15 seconds of that was on Patreon. Also, at $15 tier and above, when we actually debut the video, they're going to be there live with us. There you are, dear listener.
Buy our merch.
Buy our merch indeed. A child shall lead them.
All right, you guys. DJ Stream here. DJ Nick in the house. Whoop. The next song on our 70s night, 70s jams, is going to be Head East. Never Been Any Reason. It's a live audio. So that'll be interesting. Secondly, there's literally almost every single one of these bands we've never heard of tonight. So I'm sure some of them were pretty popular. And this just shows our ignorance.
Okay. So this is a band called Head East. And this song is Never Been what?
Never Been Any Reason.
Never Been Any Reason. Let's do it.
Would you welcome A&M recording artist, Head East!
Are you still warmed up just a little? Can y'all keep your hands over the air?
What?
Did you say we're not worthy?
Yeah. Okay, dear listener.
Interesting.
Interestante.
Don't you feel like the performers back then were so much more, like, on 10? Not, like, than all performers now, but I feel like sometimes, like, performers now don't get it. Like, they don't perform.
Correct.
They just, like, bring their music forward.
Forward!
But
well, yeah, I talked about a time I went to a music something or whatever, and a guy came out in, like, short shorts, a t-shirt, and sandals. I was like, what the hell?
He was metal?
Yeah, that's a metal band. I mean, the guy, he's no longer, he went to the next world. So I'm not going to say who it was, but subhanAllah.
Really?
Yeah, it came out in,
yeah, okay, not cool.
You know, but I'm like, yeah, come on, bro. Yeah. But,
Terrible.
But I agree with you. Like, these dudes, they understood, like, we're doing a show. This is entertainment. Mm-hmm. These people spent a bunch of money for these tickets.
Yeah.
Let's show them something. And I understand, like, the grunge scene kind of killed that, right? Because prior to the grunge scene, you had the 80s hair metal and the big production, and everything was, like, overproduced, and the music was overproduced and everything. Mm-hmm. So then these guys in Seattle went the other direction. So it's just Kurt and his flannel, mm-hmm. you know, being miserable. You know what I'm saying? But it was... You know how pendulums always swing, and you had to kind of balance it out. But what I would argue is that presentation is still a form of performance art. See what I'm saying?
Okay.
That's still performance art.
You
know what I mean?
Because I guess,
it's still not showing up in your sandals, and like, because Kurt was still putting out.
Yeah, no, I can see what you're saying. I can see what you're saying, yeah.
And
because it fits the way that they were.
Seduct.
Yeah.
And Pearl Jam. They were still, I mean, good night. Eddie Vedder went up to the top of the thing and threw himself off. You know what I'm saying? Like, he's thinking about killing himself. Like, you're like, holy shit, that boy's really thinking about that. You know what I'm saying?
Is that the point when he did that?
No, I'm not saying that. I'm just saying it just shows you, like, he wasn't talking shit.
Uh-huh,
like,
yeah.
He was really crazy.
Yeah.
He was really a crazy person.
Oh, I see what you're saying.
You know
saying.
What I'm saying?
Yeah.
But when you come out in shorts and a t-shirt and sandals and you're talking about, oh, it's like, come on, bruh.
Mm-hmm.
Same thing with Korn. Like, Korn's Woodstock performance is the great, I don't care. It was the greatest metal performance you're ever gonna see. Mm-hmm. It was completely inside outing, like completely wow. Like I'm gonna take what's inside and outside everybody in that freaking band. Like, it completely converted me to metal. These guys got it, but like you said, like in that time period, it just looked like everybody understood. Like,
yeah, there was a certain code. Like, if you're gonna be there, yeah, it's show business, right? And so it wasn't just like, even let's say the guy comes out with flip flops and a t-shirt. And you're like, meh. But if he puts on an amazing performance...
Maybe, are you not entertained?
Maybe you don't notice it as much at the end. But if you put on a mediocre performance and you come out dressing like you didn't even try, then yeah.
Yeah, I don't... yeah, no, I agree. Beyonce, you know, Beyonce is not the strongest singer of all time, but she's the strongest performer in her generation.
Next
and it's
level,
not even,
yeah.
It's not even close. She goes for it. This guy can really, really sing live, man.
Mm-hmm.
I guess he left this band and then joined a Christian band named Petra, which is really interesting.
Hmm. Wait,
Petra is where the 144 elect Jews are supposed to flee.
Did we do a song
Nikolai
by them?
Carpathia. Petra? Yeah, during Christian Week we did.
Okay.
So it's the same guy.
Oh, okay.
It's
all right.
The same singer.
All right.
But yeah, did you see any action? Did you make... I this is another relationship song. Holy shit.
What's going on here?
Did you see any action? Did you make any friends? Would you like some affection before... Oh, okay. So this dude is talking to he's talking to a young lady
mm-hmm.
that really likes him before he goes off to tour.
Well, it...
I think she's saying,
for some reason, thought that he was talking to his child because he says, I've been walking behind you since you've been able to see. So for some reason, I took that as like from the second
see
you were born.
That there's never been any reason for you to think about me.
There's never been any reason for you to think about me. Yeah.
Yeah. That's what she's talking about, his ability to see, not see as in child. I think
Wait. Okay. All right. Yeah, yeah, okay. So see Goldberg again? Yeah. So who's talking? Did you see any action? Did you make any friends? He's talking?
I think they're talking to each other. I think she might be saying, did you see any action? Did you make any friends?
That makes sense.
And he's saying, well, would you like some action before I leave? Affection before I leave again. Because he's got to go tour.
Mm-hmm.
She's saying, well, I've been walking behind you since you've been able to see. There's never been any reason for you to think about me. Mm-hmm. Because you're a big rock star. You're performing to thousands of people.
I think that's her question. Did you see any action? Did you make any friends? She wants to know. Just tell me what's going on. Did you meet anybody? Something going on? What's happening?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
You know.
Yeah.
You can ask all those questions you want. It doesn't matter. If they're bent on not seeing only you, and they do make friends or they do have some action, they won't tell you.
I don't know about that.
I don't think so.
I'd tell you.
You? And you think you're the norm? You wouldn't put yourself in that situation to begin with. Well, no. I mean, if it was making friends. I think she's trying to find...
in that situation.
Yeah, I'm thinking
if I was a young rock star without any kids... If I was in my 20s touring the world, what do you mean I wouldn't put myself in that situation?
For all that action if you were with me?
Well, not with you. But if
That's
I was,
why I said you wouldn't put yourself in that
your
situation.
Grace, if I was with you, I would just take you. I'd say, let's get the fuck out of Maine.
Yeah.
And let's go. We're going on tour. That's
true.
It.
True.
But if it was some other girl, I mean, hell yeah, of course. What do you mean?
And then you tell her, yeah, I was doing this.
Yeah,
I'd
say, yeah, I was going around. I'll tell you what, them girls in the Philippines, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, I wouldn't lie about it. You listen to rap, you think those rappers lie about it? We don't lie about that shit. That's y'all. We don't lie about that shit.
And then what are they... Oh, that's so weird.
Take them out the hood. Keep them looking good. But I don't fucking need them. First time they fuss, I'm breezing. Talking about, what's the reason? I'm pimping every sense of the word, ma. But I trust and believe them. In the cut where I keep them. See what I'm saying? Like, we don't lie about that shit. Beep, beep.
Gosh. Oh
huh?
Gosh.
Many chicks want to put chicken's fist and cuss, divorce him and split his buck. Just because you got good head, I'm supposed to break bread so you can be living it up. Shit, I part with nothing. Y'all be fronting me, give my heart to a woman. Not for nothing. Never happened. I'll be forever macking.
Yes, I've heard this one many times.
Yeah, like, so... Why would he lie about that? Like, it's not like he's married to her. You know what I'm saying? No? Yes? Yes? No?
Yeah, I guess.
What are you thinking
probably
about?
Probably right.
Tell me.
Well, no, I mean, I'm just saying that, you know, obviously from my experience and the people that I've known, but again, I came from a small circle. It was never like that. Like, the people would just lie to you. They'd lie to this one. Everybody was getting lied to. And then here you come saying, what? I just say that shit out loud. Well... Yeah, but that's not the experience that I've known or any of the girls that I've known have had for an experience where a guy would just say, oh, yeah, I met this super hot girl. We did this, this, and this, blah, blah, blah. Like, what of it?
But would anybody believe that? That you're a giant rock star in your 20s and you're not married and you're going all over the world, but he's staying true to you back in the small town? Which girl would believe that nonsense? She doesn't believe it.
I would have believed it.
She doesn't believe it. That wasn't even Big Your Pac, ladies and gentlemen. That was Jay-Z. You don't know who Jay-Z is, you ignoramus, Amy Lee? She says, I've been walking behind you since you've been able to see. There's never been a reason for you to think about me.
Yeah.
So she knows it, and she's right. Mostly. I think when he's done with his group, he's probably thinking about her. You know what I'm saying?
Babe, wow, that makes me so angry.
Why would that make you angry?
When he's done with his groupies, then he'll think about her?
Yeah, what about it?
That is so disrespectful.
He's made no commitment to her, Your Grace.
Well, how do you know he's made no commitment to her?
She said it!
Oh, where?
There's never been a reason for you to think about me. If you made a commitment to her, she wouldn't say that to him.
Well, oh my God, okay. Yeah, but then did you have any bad dreams?
Companion?
Did you break any glass?
Would you be my companion? Is there even a chance?
So you think that's her talking?
I just don't think that they're together like that. You know what I'm saying? They're not together like that. There's obviously that tension, but there's not like she wants him and he kind of wants her, but you know.
Oh my gosh, you're right. Have you ever been lonely? Do you ever have any fun? Do you ever think of me? I'm just another one. Yeah, you never give me no answer. You never tell me the truth. There's to my point. There's never been a reason for me to think about you. There's never been a reason. Oh my gosh. Woman with a sweet loving. Better than a white line. I guess maybe that was supposed to be wine. Don't you know? She could bring a good feeling. Ain't had in such a good time. Save my life. I'm going down for the last time. Whoa. So what do you think he's saying? So she's trying to find out what's going on with you to say, hey, like, is there any chance that we could ever be a thing? And what is he saying? No?
Well, I think he's torn. And it is relevant to say that this guy ended up leaving, you know, rock and roll and joining a Christian band. So I don't think that that the sex, drugs, and rock and roll lifestyle is necessarily as glamorous as he feels it is. But at the same time, if you're a young man in your 20s, you're at the height, you know, you're playing. I don't think it's disrespectful that he thinks about her afterwards. I don't think that's disrespectful. I think it's like, look, man, you're a young man, blah, that shit is in front of you, whatever. And then after, it's like, yeah, but this is kind of an empty feeling. And then your mind drifts towards the woman of substance. And maybe she was part of the reason that he left the whole thing and got saved and started a Christian band. We don't know.
Yeah. I wasn't looking at it all like that. I'm just looking at it as, like, once he takes care of his business, now all of a sudden he has time to think about
look at other Amy. Things. Amy didn't even know one of Jay-Z's most popular songs. Here she is saying he's overrated. I love it when people do that.
Amy.
I love it. I love it when people do that.
Put yourself in timeout.
You didn't even know. You didn't even know one of his biggest songs. No. She said I was channeling Biggie. Beloved, Big was dead for like 5 years when that song came out.
She's too young to remember.
She's too young. That's true.
Okay. All right. Oh, look at M. Death fan.
Well, yeah. I mean, it's true. That's a real thing. I mean, I wouldn't characterize it that way, but I think that that's what's going on.
Wow. Okay. I
think that that's what's going on. And I think as long as he hasn't made any real solid commitment to her, I don't think it's disrespectful.
Yeah, I guess. I don't like that. I don't like that at all. Like, because I think I just could see how, I don't know. You're right. People should just make sure there's commitments. Is there a commitment or is there not a commitment?
And
if they're not making a commitment, you'd have to say, why?
That's what I'm going to tell the girls. Dudes are very slick about that.
Yeah.
Dudes are very slick about that. Girl put the feeling out there and you know, this is the whole read my mind thing. This is why I tell you, like, train the girls to say exactly what they want and be explicit about exactly what they want. And don't assume the dude's going to read her mind, because there are a lot of times when the dude does read her mind, but because he hasn't technically said anything, he can be like, yo, I never said that. What do you mean?
Right.
And I know that because I've done that millions of times.
I know.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So I'd be like, whoa. I'd be like, oh, whoa. You didn't say that. There's a misunderstanding here. I never said that we are. Hey. You know what I'm saying? So that's why I'm telling you, like,
oh my God.
I'm working on with especially one of them. Be as explicit. Tell me exactly what you want. Do not tell me to read between the lines, because I'm telling you, dudes are going to figure that shit out and they're going to use it against you. So if you want a commitment, ladies, tell the guy you want the commitment, which is what Beyonce tried to tell you, ladies. If you liked it, you should have what?
Put a ring on it.
Do what you will with that, dear listener. Do what you will with that. But this is a perfect example. Okay, where do you get the song?
I'm really liking these picks. I mean,
I know. It's very, 9.2. Very, very hard. It's
9.2.
Very difficult to rate these things.
9.2.
Sorry laughing as if she can spit any bars. Actually,
I can spit bars.
She can really, really rap.
So fuck you, baby.
No, she really, really can rap. It's unbelievable. I was in the shower. You wrote that whole shit while I was in the shower, right?
Yeah. I have to be in a certain space.
I came out of the shower and she just went, wah! I was like, holy shit. You're funny. She can rap. Okay. Okay.
What did you give it?
Shit, man. No, there's more songs coming.
Oh, yeah. We got a bunch more.
I don't know how to... This guy's got too many good songs. I feel like he's putting, like, the band's best songs. prior to today, I had a good streak where I wasn't giving away even nines, much less tens. Mm-hmm. 8.9. Gonna give it an 8.9. What did you give it?
9.2.
There you are, dear listener. If you are among the righteous, then you're tight. We got more songs coming for you. I don't know, Nick. I think Nick.
I know Nick's killing it.
He's massacring.
It's so funny too because he was like, just start the stream between 8:30 and 8:45, like it's just some mediocre thing. Like just
yeah,
do that.
Yeah.
Meanwhile,
you see the confidence. Just start it, you plebe.
Yeah.
Is that what Dory does?
Yeah.
You plebe. Go ahead.
All right. Shout out to DJ Nick. We're coming back with more songs.
Maybe the next three or four songs will be trash.
Yeah,
and
so
then
I can
be like, oh, Nick, you fell off here, buddy.
Maybe you can throw a Beatles song in there so I can give it a 3.5.
Guarantee you a positive review.
Get out. Sorry, out.
Go.